It is indeed a pleasure to bring devotion. I just want to give God thanks for giving me the opportunity to do this once again. This morning, my devotion is entitled, Blessings Are Found in Our Brokenness. When I heard Dr. Esther's devotion yesterday, I said, the Lord is moving, because it's basically something similar. Let us pray. Kindly Father, we give you thanks and praise. Father, we thank you that you've woken us up this morning, God, in our right minds. You have given us another day, Father. We ask that you order our steps according to your will and your plan for our life today. Father, as we get into your word, Father, let it plant roots in our hearts. Father, let it resonate with us, oh God. For those of us that are going through stuff that has caused us to be in that broken state, help us to know that you are always beside us, oh God. You never leave us nor forsake us, your word said. As Sis Angela said this morning, you're a God who cannot lie, and you never change. God, we give you thanks and praise. Let me decrease and let your sweet Holy Spirit increase right now. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Blessings are found in our brokenness. Scripture referencing from Psalms 34, 18, and it says, the Lord is near to the brokenhearted and save those who are crushed in spirit. Is your heart broken today? Is your spirit crushed? The psalmist David experienced some intense highs and fierce lows, but he recognized God's presence in the midst of his circumstances. He knew that God was near and God could change any situation in an instant. Sometimes when we are broken, when we feel downcast and downtrodden, we think that we are all alone. But no, we are not. God is near to us. He hasn't left you to fight for yourself. He sees you in your heartbreak. He meets you where you are. He has not forgotten you. This verse says that God is near to those who are broken. What a blessing. Do you know that God can use your brokenness more than your gifts and your talents? Life has a lot of hardships, and the way we respond is important. Our response can be compared to an egg. If an egg is broken from the outside, life ends. But if it is broken from the inside, life begins. Great things always begin from the inside. Like an egg, life hatches from the inside. Life always has external pressures that threatens to break us. If you break from the outside, life ends because you become fearful and full of self-pity. Don't let the hardships of life break you down emotionally, spiritually, or mentally. Instead, choose to surrender to the Holy Spirit and be broken on the inside, because that's where life begins. In this present world, there are so many things that gets us down. We might lose a loved one. We might hardship in our marriages, in our jobs, and all these things tend to crush us down and leave us heartbroken and leave us downtrodden. But God says he will never leave us nor forsake us. Friends, God feed the multitude with the brokenness of our lives. The bread had to be broken in the hands of Jesus before he could miraculously feed the multitude. The anointing oil flowed when the alabaster box was broken. So in order for God to use us, sometimes he has to break us and mold us and shape us back in the way that he wants us to go. So when circumstances and situations come in our lives, don't always think that it's for the detriment of us. Sometimes it's God's using it to take us down the path that he wants us to go. Don't ever give up. Life trials may come, but persevere. As Sister Esther said yesterday, persevere to the end. You never know what is at the end of all of the hardship that you are going through. Even Jesus had to allow himself to be broken on the cross for salvation and healing, for our salvation and healing. And because of this, we have constant access to God's presence and comfort through the Holy Spirit. Remember, blessings are found in brokenness. From brokenness come great breakthroughs. From our brokenness comes great breakthroughs. So if your heart's breaking and your spirit is crushed, know that you are in good hands. God is near and he will not abandon you. In Psalms 147:3 says, he heals the brokenhearted and bind up the wounds. In Psalms 55:22, he says, cast your burdens on the Lord and he will sustain you. He will never permit the righteous to be moved. In Psalms 62:8, he says, trust in the Lord at all times. O people, pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us, Selah. Psalm 71:20 says, though you have made me to see troubles, many and bitter, you will restore my life again from the depths of the earth. You will again bring me up. Psalm 73:26 says, my flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Lamentation 3:22 says, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. John 1:5, the light shines in the darkness and the darkness has not overcome it. So when we think that we are alone and this trouble seems to be drowning us out, just turn to God's scripture. He is always beside us. There's so many other scriptures, like John 16:33 says, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world, you will have trouble. He didn't say may. He said, you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world. So we will have troubles. We will have these things coming our way. But God says he will be with us in the midst of our troubles. So remember, he hasn't left you to fight for yourself. He sees you in your heartbreak. He meets you where you are. He has not forgotten you. So don't look at your brokenness as a curse, but look at it as blessings are found in your brokenness. God bless you and have a good day. Kind of Father, I just want to thank you, Father, for those of us who are going through, God. Help us to know that you are near. You said you will never leave us nor forsake us, God. And God, help us to wait on you. Help us to stick it out, to see what's the end of whatever situation you're taking us through. Father, we ask to bless each and every person on this ministry right now. Continue to bless them, continue to keep them, and continue to guide them. We give you all praise. We give you all honor and all glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.